Welcome you to Trinity this evening. I see a lot of familiar faces, so they're probably parents, loved ones, others, so we're delighted that you're here to join with the choir, the musicians, in praising the Lord this evening. Well, we're going to open in prayer, so would you please join me as we thank our God together. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this evening, for these musicians, the work that they've put in, and the beautiful music that we're going to enjoy. We want to praise your name together as we listen to the music. We pray you'll give them calmness in their hearts as they sing. May it just be a joyful time of celebration and praise to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Sauti,
Irina Sime.
praise the Father, praise the Son, and praise the Spirit, three in one.
Amen.
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 Amen. to take a moment to reset, bring our orchestra out for the next portion of our program. The piece we just sang was by young composer Joshua Rodriguez, who is a music theory and composition teacher at California Baptist University. Our next set will begin with the newest piece that he has composed for choir, and we are among the co-commissioners of the piece. We're really excited to present. We'll say a little bit more about that. Take about 5 minutes. Feel free to stand and stretch. We'll be back in 5 minutes. Malcolm Guite is an English clergyman, poet. He's written a number of sonnets, an entire set of sonnets based on each of the Psalms, 150 Psalms, sonnets for the various seasons of the church year. The poem that is set in our next piece is an unpublished poem that, that Josh Rodriguez got permission to set in a conversation between the two of them, deciding what it is that he would handle next. When I knew that Joshua was going to, was preparing another project with a poem by Malcolm Guite, having already sung I See Your World in Light, I jumped on board and said, absolutely, we want to get behind this and be part of the commission. And then he produced a piece that's extraordinarily different from what you've just heard. And it's been, I hope, our great delight to learn this piece this semester. What you will have noticed if you're looking at the text, or as you look at it while we read, is that this is a very dramatic text set in those hours between the crucifixion of our Lord and the reality, the knowledge that in fact he still lives, set very poetically. And I believe you'll clearly grasp at what point the life of the disciples changed. So we're glad to present the Midwest premiere. This piece has been performed one other time by Josh's own institute, the California Baptist University. We're just delighted to be able to present this, this breathless earth for you tonight.
We could not catch our
breath.
have perhaps noticed a few of our singers have boutonnieres on tonight. They are seniors who are graduating. They are finishing their undergraduate career here. I see some fingers snapping, parental fingers snapping. So we just wanted to acknowledge them, to call them out for their faithfulness to choir, and to wish them well as they move on to the next activity, next thing in their life. They've been students here and have been singing in the choir. First, would you please stand, Lexi? Lexi Garcia. Lexi is one of those choristers who is every choir director's dream and fear that they'll fall in love and get married in choir. And so Lexi's married to Lucas, who graduated last year. She's a Christian ministries major. She's been in choir for her 4 years. She's the chaplain of the choir this year. Great organizer for us. She's also been involved with volleyball here on campus and with women's ministries. And Lexi, we've been so delighted to have you here. And that you've noticed not only her boutonniere, but her smile tonight. Thank you, Lexi. Glad to have you here. Thank you. And then second, Caleb Engelhardt. I wasn't going to say anything about any of the seniors, except I knew this would embarrass Caleb, so I had to do it.
Oh, yeah.
Caleb is a psychology major. He's been in choir for his 4 years. Among my favorite moments in choir is seeing what show t-shirt Caleb would be wearing when he comes to choir, what musical, Broadway musical t-shirt he would be wearing. I'm going to miss that special aspect of his time with us. He has a characteristic wry or droll wit and is a typical cynical bass, and I'm also going to miss that as well. But he will still be on campus because he's going to continue here and pursuing a master's degree in mental health counseling. Thank you, Caleb. Next to Caleb is Noah Swift. Noah is a... He's a music major with an emphasis in business administration. Noah's a classical guitarist, and he's a fine classical guitarist. In my freshman year of college, a century ago, my first day on campus, I met a classical guitarist, the first classical guitarist I'd ever seen. I thought they were just people who lived in Pineville somewhere. And somehow God has brought classical guitarists into every season of my life, and I'm so thankful, Noah, that you've been a part this season of classical guitar for me, and both for his musicianship and also for his really gentle personality. What is a classical guitarist doing in the choir? Well, we closed down our wind ensemble, and what was he doing in a wind ensemble? He had to participate in something, so he became a percussionist, and a very fine percussionist. And so he's a very flexible, adaptable, and delightfully gracious music student. Unfortunately for Noah, he has taken every music major class that I teach. So he really does deserve to get out of here. And he thought he would get off singing in choir, but then we had to shut down the wind ensemble. So thank you, Noah. And then lastly, among the graduates, I'd like to highlight Minor. She's had a very very rigorous program here. She'll finish her studies this summer, effectively having worked on this degree and its minor in 3 years. She's focused her instrumental studies in piano, a very fine pianist, and it's a delight to hear her play Chopin especially. She's been involved in worship music on campus, both in chapel and in the Thursday night free student worship, student-led worship. So Erin, we're going to miss you. Thank you for being part of our team. I should say too that Erin also had been involved in the wind ensemble, and for a while in both, and also is playing piano there and picking up percussion duties. I want to mention Jose Rodriguez, whom you're going to hear later in the piece Evening Prayer. Jose is graduating this year. He's not in choir, so they wouldn't spring for a boot year for him. Sorry, Jose. Ensemble, the jazz ensemble. It's willingly and joyfully, collaboratively played. When I've asked him, would you do something with us in chapel? Would you play with choir, whatever? And again, Jose, we're going to miss you having you around. We're so glad you are able to play with us tonight. So we're going to continue with our next set, and Arthur Williams is going to direct. Arthur and Ruth, who directed in the first set, both taught the choir the pieces that they're directing without any music in front of us. They taught us our parts. They led us through. They've directed these things in chapel, and it's just been a real privilege to have student conductors who bring their heart and their joy into it. Arthur is going to lead us in total praise.
Thank you.
Very briefly, just two more people to acknowledge. I want to mention Amy McCausland, who has been our choir accompanist. She's more than a choir accompanist, but she's here. They're like that when I thank her at the end of a rehearsal. So, Amy, you are loved, and we are thankful for your time with us. She's also unofficially the assistant director, and we've worked together with the choir since 2017. Amy's the mother of four young children. She is finishing this semester a Master of Arts here in Trinity, a Master of Arts in Mental Health Counseling, while her husband, Stephen, is finishing his PhD in Educational Studies. I don't know how you do it, but I'm glad that you do. So, Amy, we are thankful, and I think someone has something. Okay, good. I don't have my bicycle mirror on today, right? And I do want to mention also that helping us on keyboards tonight is Amy's mother, Connie Borden. So, Connie, thank you. And, Connie came up from Louisville to be part of this, and I suppose to see Amy graduate. But anyway, so. And also, Don Hedges, would you come down front, please? I want to acknowledge Dr. Don Hedges. Sing the rest of our program, but you can do that as long as you want because it won't be enough. Don has been at Trinity since 1999, 23 years. He is a professor of music. He has taught theory, and he's been the department chair in music. He's been the division director and the humanities division. He's been an assistant dean, an associate dean, an interim dean. He's been a friend. He's been a model to me, an example of grace under fire. Don has shown me in a beautiful way how to disagree agreeably, how to hold high standards with even higher kindness. I teach at Trinity because Don took a risk in having me come as an adjunct and kept finding ways for me to stay. But many people could say the same thing. We are just so thankful, Don, for your friendship and for your ministry here in Trinity College. And Don has accepted a position to teach at the Master's College in Los Angeles, where he will begin in the fall. And Don, we're so thankful. Don is also he's produced programs like this. He's directed stage plays, musical director for musicals here on campus. I'm not sure there's anything he hasn't done, including teaching every course that I ever taught, and I think a lot more besides. So all the history, all the theory, all the church music, at some time or other over Don's 23 years, he's done it all. So we're glad that someone else gets to enjoy your friendship and your gifts. So thank you, Don. Thank you.
Services there. I remember a Christmas communion service that he led. I have been over the years impressed. I don't know anybody who does more things better than Chuck King. He, in fact, when he was talking about Noah Swift a few minutes ago, he said that he was adaptable and flexible and gracious, and Noah is all of those things. But those are things that I could have said that I can observe in Chuck in spades. It is a privilege, has been a privilege to work with him. It's been a privilege to work with all of you, and especially over this COVID time, it's been a privilege to see God work in all that he has done. And now that Professor King gets to direct this group without masks on, that's a special pleasure. And to invite you all into that is a great thing as well. So we are pleased and thankful to God that you are here, that you joined us tonight. Thank you, Dean Robel. Thank you, Paul and Ravia back there in the, we appreciate you. And thank you, Chuck, for putting together yet another program that honors God, in which we have seen Jesus together. Let everything that has breath praise him. Good night.